Hello. Okay. So can you tell me anyone what why data model is important and where now we used?
Data model is something like in 5.4 we have one rule for setting all the property values.
Sometimes that is model, okay. There is not a data model, there is a model which we need to initiate the properties.
Okay.
Anyone have an answer on this? See, right now the scenario which we gave, right, we just have the skeleton of the scenario and now we need to work on the data model. Okay, so data model defines how the case is persisted with. Okay, so when we created our application, you people notice that we got created with a data class also, right? Some basic data class which is in organization level. See, that is data objects is different. I am talking about data classes. When you initiate your data object, it does not create any data class. Okay, it just creates the object with which you want to interact with your built-on application case. That is data objects. So now we are going to see how what is the impact of property and how we are going to define your data model. Take an example, the application which we are going to work, client onboarding, which requires the data structure, right? So we need to find out how we are going to segregate from our work to data.
Okay.
We have three concepts, like one is the rule, work, data, right?
Yeah. Yes.
Which you people are creating as a rule, work, the instance you are initiating is like a work. And data is like what you are working on the work. The Pega recommends we should not store the data information on the work. Remember, right? On PV work page. So data is very important and you should not keep it at your work page most of the time. You can bring it whenever you want to show on the screen. You can modify it and you can do some processing. That's what I'm talking about, the second point. Each stage has taken example
because of some security issue.
Not security issue, you don't want to load the your work object.
Okay.
So sometimes we use our data classes and storing our data information outside of our work. Whenever we want, we can bring it out, right?
Yes.
So defer load concept is the same way, right? Whenever we want, we can load that information to the screen, that is on the clipboard, and then we show to the user. The same way, we don't want to store any attachment to the work object. Pega says Pega is not for enterprise case management. Pega is not a content management. You got it right? Pega is not a content management, because when you are attaching any a document to the work object, what will happen, it attached to your data work attached, and whenever you are processing your work object, whenever you want to open your work object, it's like a huge volume.
So yeah,
we don't want to do all kind of stuff, and data model is very important. If you are using everyone is on the mute. I'm getting echo. Okay, so one can switch on. Whenever you want to talk, you can switch on your speaker, mic. Take an example, you people are creating your, configuring your forms, right, now. So what will happen when you configure form? You enter first name and last name, right? Where it get created? Anyone? Santosh, Arun, Durga? You're on mute.
Kartik.
Hello.
Hello.
Karthik,
can you come again once? I'm not.
See, you people are created stages, and inside stages you created multiple steps, and each steps you are configuring, right?
Okay.
Configure all details.
Yeah.
So that means you're entering some properties which you want to create and display on the screen. So can you tell me where is getting created? Which class is getting created?
In the work class.
So the information which you are processing, it's no need of present in the work class, right?
Yeah.
But Pega out of the box is creating in the work class, but how your data structure should be, keep your data should keep away of your work.
Using this data, we need to create the data classes, and we can put all the properties over there.
Correct. So we talked about rule, work, data, right? We call one is called integration, right? INT class.
Yeah.
So whenever you go for INT class, you are going to interact with your external system, and you are going to bring some data, correct?
Yes, yes.
So your integration class will also have contains about other class called data class. From the data class, what are the values you are getting it, you are going to store it with your work object as a page or page list or individual property.
Yes.
So it's good that we always keep our data away of our work. It's easy to bring out whenever you want to do it. And it's reusable in the business model. Take an example, if you are creating any XYZ in my organization, right? XYZ-data-, I can have like contact details is my class name, and details of the property is like a first name, last name, date of birth, and employee start date and end date. I can reuse across any work classes.
Yes.
So that's how your data model should be. And it's also reusability, and it's also like very easy to extend, and it's avoid the duplication. Yesterday some people are asking where to create property, right? In case if you are creating property or onboarding, sometimes you may not able to see in background or admin or user provisioning. So if you create a property in a XYZ-data class, it's visible to all the classes. So it's avoid duplication. Okay.
Okay.
That's why I talk about the first point here, like where and all we use data, right? We used all the pieces of the data, showing the user interface and processing and also reports and every other integrations. So wherever we go, we see the data. And you people all know about all the types of the property and modes of the property, right?
Yes, yes, Kathy.
So single value. So these are the property types, right? Single value, value list, value group, page list, and page group. So what we called as a single value? What are the properties we called as a single value?
A property which holds only the single value, I mean an integer, like that, text, decimal.
Yeah, so these are the properties we called as a single value, right?
Yeah.
You create it as a text or integer or decimal, date, date time, true, false, password, data object. So all those properties are single value properties. It holds only one value.
Yeah.
So, and go back to previous screen. Value list and value group, how we different?
A value list is
like an array group of values.
Okay.
Value of one, value of two, value of two, like that it contains list of values.
Okay.
And value group means the index is not an integer, but it contains a text. Value of
so
home, value
it
of home.
Applies to same pages and page group, right?
Yeah.
So what is the difference you are seeing from value list, value group, and pages and page group?
Value list contains values, whereas page list contains pages, a set of pages.
any other difference?
Value list is a single type of work. Data will be there in page list. There will be different data types will be there.
Okay, so that means like page list is like having multiple pages and it contains multiple properties.
Yeah. Yes. Multiple data types.
It's like a single value and value group, values and value group are a single properties. So it's always recommend to go with page and page list whenever you are designing your applications. Okay.
Okay. Okay.
So this is what the example which we have. Take an example. You are having a contractor details over here, right? In case if you want to have multiple contractor details on the same page. Okay. So you are inputting only one contact details right now, but in case if you have a multiple contact details, you want to create a single request for multiple contact details, what we can do, we can create a data class and add the property first name, last name and middle initial name and property which you want to create, and then define those, create a page list property in your work class, and then give the classes, that is data class name as page list input. Okay, so when you are giving input in the repeated layout, you will get person 1, person 2, person 3, right? What are the details you want to enter? It's like an individual person is like an individual class for us, and then person 1, person 2, person 3 are like a pages for us.
Yes.
So today what you people are going to work out as, you people are creating properties on work class, right? So now you have to design all your properties should be on the data class and you should work on the work page.
Okay.
So we have provided first step is like contact details, and then second step is educational person and immigration details, right? So all the properties you have to define in your data class and then bring it on the work class.
Okay, Kathy.
So this is what you are going to do today, and how you are going to create your data object. Like you have an option of data explorer on your left navigation, right?
Yeah.
Data explorer. So go to Data Explorer here, add remote data objects. Create new. And choose your class. Rule sets and where you want to keep it. After clicking, it will prompt you what are the properties your data objects have it. You see here all my data which I entered, it was created a data class and it has properties got created. So these properties, how you want to refer in your screen, create a page property in your work object and then refer this class as a page property. So I'm creating as a I mentioned as a single page. So your property got created with a mode of page and it contains my contact details class. Got it, Santosh?
Yeah, got it.
So now you will have to design your data model for the application scenario which we gave and
okay.
Prepare it. I will review it. Also, I will check about the what is the error on submit action now. Okay.
Okay.
Okay, Santu. So please ask question in case if you have any question in between you preparing your data model. Okay.
Okay.
Yeah. Yeah, your ID should be like your class. What is your organization name?
That is IGT5.
Yeah, delete the entire ID now. IGT. We have data, right? Yeah, hyphen. Your what is the class you want to create? This is already existing class hyphen. Your contact details is a class, right? You have to enter. You are creating a class now. You are creating a data class now, Santosh.
Okay, sir. So the same ID will be the parent this class, right?
No, you can leave it. No issues.
It is a parent.
Is that the load to decrease the load on work object, right?
Correct, but this is also a reusable concept, right? You can have it your pages in your work class and property defined outside of your work class, that is data class, and you can reuse across the place.
Okay, for reusability.
Reusability.
Okay, so at the database, yeah, Kati.
This is like your foundation, right? So you want to design an application, how you can reusable and how you should extend your application, right?
Okay, okay.
So if you created in your work class, take an example in onboarding. So if you thought the same thing is applied to your admin, you are going to create one more?
Okay, okay. Okay,
so what you will do the time you keep moving all the rules to work class, right? On top.
Yeah.
So take an example if you are using the same kind of properties in integrations.
Okay.
So that time you are interacting with your data class also, right?
Yeah.
So you need data classes. So that's why we told keep your all data outside of your work now.
Okay. Okay, got it.
Okay.
Okay, okay, thanks.
Okay.
Karthik?
Yeah?
Since I will be using the same properties even in the BGC class, so I have to create another page using the data class in the BGC, and we have to do data propagation from this parent to BGC, right?
So you can pass a page.
So we don't need to create properties again.
So you are creating an onboard, right?
Ah, yes.
Okay, then you have to do it. Yes, correct. If you are creating the work, then it will be propagate. If you are creating in the onboard, then yes, you have to do that in the same.
Okay.
So better to keep it in the work. Your page is our page definition, keep it in the work class.
You need to say the property which we created now based on the data class, you want us to keep in the work class.
Yes, correct.
Okay.
Arun? Arun?
Karthik, you want to
start? Sadhar, I'm logging out in your ID, okay? You can try it.
Okay.
And Arun is there?
Yeah, he's there. You want to?
Arun?
Yeah, 1 minute. I think there is a problem with his mic.
Okay, no problem.
Hello, Karthik.
Arun?
Hello, Karthik.
Yeah, your voice is very low.
Actually, I'm resolving one child object.
Arun, I will give you a present access. And your voice is very low.
Hello?
It's not audible, son.
Are you hearing now?
One second. Somewhat okay, but not 100%.
Actually, I'm resolving one child object, Karthik.
Can you share your screen?
Okay, okay.
Arun? Hello? Arun?
Karthik, I think Arun's mic is not working, so there is a problem. He's just sharing his screen.
Yeah, I'm seeing the screen, but I want to know what he's talking
about. I think he will be chatting with you.
Arun, chat.
Can you run the process, Arun? Can you run the process, Arun?
Hello, Karthik.
Yeah, Arun.
Yeah, actually, I mean, you are able to see my screen, no?
Yeah, Karthik. Yes.
Could it speak loud?
Now, good?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Actually, we will create one worker object here. One left. Yes.
This is your parent, right?
Yeah, yeah. Actually, I mean, I did like in PY default.
Okay.
Here, BGC is the covered object.
Okay.
Automatic instantiation required. Okay. I mentioned.
Okay.
So it has to be fulfilled. So I'm submitting the flow now, completing the parent, but it will show. I mean, it has to be created. I mean, it has to be finished. So I'm trying to finish it. Personal details. Actually, I'm resolving now after this step. I will show you that. This is the stage.
Open in case designer, that will be easy.
Legal auth migration. I'm resolving here by using one update status activity.
Okay.
Resolve completed. I think update status will resolve the work object, no?
Yeah.
Yeah. So now the child got resolved completed. I'm again accessing the parent.
Okay. Open the clipboard once.
Could you speak loud?
Open the clipboard.
Okay, okay. Yeah.
Go to your work page.
Yeah.
And I want to see the cover and his keys. Open the page. PR page. Open the PR page on left. Yes.
PY cover page.
Yes, correct. Yeah.
I think it will be there on the covered object. Yes.
No, can you click that and the arrow button?
Arrow button. Okay. Okay.
Yeah. See what are the cover and his keys?
Yeah, yeah. Covered and his keys.
Check how many.
Cover. Three covered.
You have user provisioning also got created, right? Admin also get created.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, I didn't mention them as required.
Automatic start, right? I think.
Automatic instantiation. Yeah.
So you didn't have any condition on the automatic creation, right? It created.
No, I don't have any condition.
You created whenever your plan got created. It getting created whenever your parent got created.
Yeah, yeah. Yes.
So have a condition and say that when you want to get created. That's why we mention about dependencies. Whether any status.
It is showing error, like I will show you. I'm approving now. BGC created but not finished. I mean, it is saying child is not yet finished. BGC.
Okay. Can you open again clipboard?
Okay.
You want to see the cover? Go to your page.
Yeah.
What is the cover count?
cover count 3.
Open is 3, right? So it's not yet resolved.
Yeah, I mean px covered count open, still it is 3 only.
3.
That means like resolve was not happened properly. Open your child object and then open the background check object. Arun?
Yeah.
Open the background check object. Open the BGC object here.
No, clipboard or?
Open the object in the portal and then open clipboard.
Okay, okay, portal, yeah.
Yeah, open in clipboard now.
Clipboard, okay.
Yeah. Go to PRC.
Let me see.
Just can scroll down. Check PY status work.
It's got it. Open.
PY status work. Scroll down, Arun.
Okay.
Yeah, down. One second. It shows resolve completed, right?
Actually, in parent clipboard, it is still showing covered count open of 3 only.
It's so not updated. That's a problem. So it's not updated.
Yeah, that is a problem.
Your cover and cover does not updated properly. How the locking system mechanism you have open?
Yeah, I'm sure. Yeah. Locking mechanism advanced. Default locking.
Can you do optimistic locking and try it?
Okay. I have to make optimistic?
Yeah, do optimistic.
Okay. Yeah, okay.
And save the rule and check in and then
save.
Log out and log in and try. Okay.
Shall I create again?
Yeah, log out and log in back and then try.
Log out and log in. Voice is very less.
Arun?
Hello, Karthik.
Yeah, what happened?
I think server hang up, it is coming.
Can you open one more session and try?
Okay.
So it's completed.
Yeah,
can
it's
you go
completed.
To open onboarding?
Okay.
And see what is the cover count status values. No, open your clipboard and see.
Okay.
Still 3, right? Okay, yeah. Satish, yeah. Okay, Arun, yeah. I will check on it and I'll get back to you.
Okay, yeah, thanks.
Okay. Okay. So please complete all the data models for onboarding. We will have some review session on tomorrow.
Okay, Karthik.
Okay. Okay. Thanks, guys.
Okay, thank you.
Karthik, one last question.
Yes, Sasha.
Nothing about this part, but see, if on mobile we have an application called Pega 7.
Yes.
Okay. If I want to configure that to the application that I am creating here, can I do it?
You can do it, but you should have Pega mobile rule set.
Yeah.
You should have Pega mobile rule set, and there is some configuration has to do because of portal is different entirely.
Mm-hmm.
The portal which you are seeing is like a developer and admin portal, right? In
okay.
normal system. Mm-hmm. If you want to see it in the Pega mobile, your portal should be configured as a mobile, and you should add some more layout actually. Yeah, you can still do it, but development point of view, it's difficult to do.
Yeah, I was trying to connect. It says authentication failed, so something was missing.
From mobile, you are trying to connect the cloud?
Yeah.
Okay.
I'm talking about Pega 7 application.
Yeah, even I have my in my mobile. Let me try and I'll update you through mail today.
Sure, sure.
Thanks. Okay. Yeah, thank you so much. Right. Thanks, guys. We'll have review session on tomorrow. Please at least complete, sir. The onboarding work case type.
Okay.
Okay.
Thank okay, Gati. Thank
any
you.
Any questions, you mail me or call me.
Okay.
Okay. Yeah. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.